So the next day, we took a trip to the Blue City, which is very famous for its being blue. None of us really ate, so we were so hungry the whole day, and it was a lot of walking.
Hey guys, so we're here in the Blue City. Just climbed 5 flights of stairs. And we're not there yet.
Oh, sounds so familiar.
Nabil says we're going to the Haven. I only picture a haven with food. We're here at the top of the goddamn mountain. This is our tour guide.
I love this place, and there are so many cats. I have never seen this many in my entire life in one place.
You've got a twin. Just another quick Stairmaster workout right after eating.
Back to where we started.
I just had a fucking plate full of bolognese.
We're going to a place called El Jefa.
Yo, who's checking into the building?
Are you checking into the building?
I'm checking out of the building right now. The tenant lot.
Okay. I walked away and I was like, I need to go.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is a Wednesday, I think, and today we are at Hercules Cave, right there, with this beautiful view of Tangier. Basically, the story goes, they say that this is where Hercules separated Africa from Europe.
Noisimos, vamonos!
Welcome to where the Mediterranean Sea meets the Atlantic Ocean.
Or they're just gone. Or they're gone forever.
This segment is sponsored by Rahul Eats. There's really a party in my tummy.
They're so cute.
Sam, this is child labor and it's hilarious.
Leaving the beach, and it was honestly the best day of my life.
I said
it was the best day of my life.
Let's go, Sam.
I had so much fun. And
Sam made friends, guys.
Yeah, these kids saw me collecting shells and stuff, so they kept bringing me rocks.
The next day, we checked out of our place in Tangier and drove to Fez. And Fez is known for being the cultural capital of Morocco, and they have a lot of shops with different types of vendors.
Okay, so we are still walking to our hotel.
We stayed in a riad, which is basically a type of Moroccan architecture where there's an interior courtyard with the house built around it. We actually had a guided tour for this place because there's a lot of cultural things that we didn't know about. We walked through the city and we started out at a mosque and then went to the shops. We went to a tannery, a fabric store, we went to a ceramics shop, blanket shop.
Aisha, what do we get?
I get blankets.
Blankets.
Cobalt blue.
Cobalt.
We're on a freaking roof, on a terrace. Let's look at the mosque. Can we get the mosque up in there? I can't see it. It's
I'm trying to get a little bit more. Let's get the tower. There we go. We've got a whole view of the mosque right here. Let's be, I'm gonna give you a little 360. Okay, I think I've spun enough.
Wow. I can't believe we did all that, guys.
Shout out to Brian.
That's time. Let's sit up, please. Yeah! Here, Mr. Rodriguez, when he was 13 years. It's
That's pretty good.
The next day, we drove to the desert, and it was a long and hot drive.
I'm eating Sahara pizza.
We just arrived here in Mizuga, and this is where the Sahara Desert is, and we're unpacking everything, and now we're waiting for our camels to come. Those are some of them, and we're getting more. Oh, say hi, say hi. Vlog.
The camel ride was really fun until Kira almost died.
Kira, please!
What's going on, guys? We just made it here and it took us about like a 2-hour camel ride. No lie. But this is where we're staying.
Huh? Yo, this is a big building. Yo.
Sand Angel.
So soft.
You are the princess in our window.
Take them.
Oh yeah, I need to take a picture of the Tajin. I haven't taken any pictures of the Tajin.
Yo, we outside too.
Raining in the
At first, it was a sandstorm, or like it was like wind blowing everywhere, and we thought sand was gonna get in our tent. But now rain is.
So we looked it up. The Sahara Desert only gets a half to a full inch
in the whole
every year.
We took our last and longest ride back to Marrakesh, back to where we started.
Hi y'all. We just got back to Marrakesh. It was like a 9-hour.
10:30 at night.
Basically a flight with three.
We were
layovers.
Just in the desert. Then we're back.
Marrakesh. Now we're back here.
What's up, y'all?
It's so nice.
MTV, welcome to my crib.
Hi yo, we're back in the city of Marrakesh, in the middle of the whole street. Hopefully we don't get hit. I'm not too sure really where we're going right now.
Yeah, just following the bill like always.
What's up guys, here in some sort of museum garden.
Hey yo, we're in the palace.
Hey yo, we in the palace beauty.
Palace.
Hi guys, we're in some kind of palace. Okay, we got Renee in this beauty.
It's called Bahia Palace.
It's called Baja Blast.
It was our last day in Morocco, so we explored Marrakesh for one last time.
Everywhere, wow.
We went to the bazaar again and ended up in one of the juice carts. And then we got our ears pierced.
We're currently in Marrakesh and we all just got our ears pierced. And it's raining again! It's raining again. And we just walked through the bazaar. It's very dark. The sky is very dark right now.
Yeah.
Lena's family cooked us one last meal, and it was amazing. And then we went out to our favorite bar.
Yo.
It's the last night.
Good morning. We are going to leave today. And now we have to wake everyone up. It's like 6:40. We wanted to leave at 7. So we'll see if people are awake.
Open up. Res live.
Kia, where are we right now?
Sam, do you have anything for the vlog?
It's been nice real. Vlog.
It's been real, Morocco. Goodbye.
I honestly can't believe me and my friends went to Morocco together. It was completely surreal. And as much fun as I had, it's always nice to come back home.